Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for another solo queue silliness here on the channel. Today I'm going to be playing as the Lord of Terror himself, Diablo, on the Haunted Mines. I should mention that I have somewhat balanced the audio issues. I have not replaced my headset yet. And for those of you who did not read the blurb on the last solo queue silliness, my headset is currently failing and only feeds the microphone through the left channel. Now, what I'm doing now, right now, is bypassing it with a USB sound card. And that seems to work, but it's kind of crappy audio like quality, to be quite frank. So forgive any like crackling or static or anything. Also, I'm still quite sick from traveling, but I'm getting better, though. I do feel better. I just have to shake the cough and the fever, and then I'll be good to go. Hopefully in a couple days. So on our team today, we've got Illidan, Vala, Raynor, Diablo, and Arthas taking on Nubarak, Nova, Tyrael, Malfurion, and Vala. So this is, should be pretty interesting. I have not unlocked Diablo's full heroic abilities and that sort of thing, so I'm still rocking and rolling with the stun, which some people consider the better of the two ultimates. And some people consider the Lightning Breath the better of the two. It's hard to say, really. I mean, Diablo, he's gotten better since the early stages, but I think that, as I've already said a couple times in the last time I played Diablo, he's still not my choice. Arthas pretty much trumps any other warrior that's out there right now. And then Diablo, I'd say, is more towards the Tier 3 warriors. He's not really good at really doing anything except initiation. He's big and stompy, and he can grab people and kind of CC them a bit. But his damage is quite laughable, and his ultimates just don't really bring him much. I mean, if you can land his ultimate, the one that stuns everybody, you know, that's good on you there. But it's very hard to land, especially due to the fact that it's so easily telegraphed. Victoria, throw him into the turrets for a little bit there. Another big problem with Diablo is that he doesn't really have a lot of poke. He's got his Shadow Charge, which is the one that you see. I'll go ahead and do it right now. There's the example. That's the Shadow Charge, which is a decent initiation, but it doesn't do that much damage. It's a pretty nice stun. But one of the biggest problems is the fact that outside of his W, which has to be augmented to get the better of the two pokes when you do the... I forget which talent it is. Let's see. It's the... It's not the 7, I think it's the 13. 16, maybe? Yeah, 16. So, the Firestorm talent, where the flames actually return back to Diablo. So you get two swings out of it instead of one with the Flame Stomp, or whatever it's called. Fire Stomp. So we have Nova here. Some people were lamenting at my comments about Nova, saying how I do feel that she is quite the broken hero, and I'll own up to it. Amplified healing, or yeah, you know what? I'm gonna amplify healing. I can't really safely go into the mines right now, and I'm waiting for. I would like to get a tap on the fountain, but I guess I'll go in with Illidan. Arthas is down there as well. I know that Nova is somewhere right around there. I can see her. And this is not a good fight for us. This is not a good fight at all. So I should have just stayed up top. Should have just stayed out of the mines. They had all five. They literally had all five down there. But anyway, on the subject of Nova, I do think that she is quite a big problem. It's easy to say, oh, well, you can get a tanky character, and all you gotta do is get inside of her range, and yeah, erp, erp. Yeah, that's certainly an argument you can make with anybody. All you have to do is counter them completely, and then you'll be completely fine. It's a very, very easy thing to say. It's harder to do in practice when you are also dual laning against another champion who may also be stealth in the form of Zeratul. I think Zeratul is much more balanced than Nova. But again, opinions. Everyone has them. None of them are right. None of them are wrong. So since they're all going for the bottom here, I'm gonna see if I can take the shadow night camp. Yeah, I don't know what the shadow camp is. I don't know what our Vala's doing though. I would love to have some help from Vala. I think our Vala player may be AFK. All right, not gonna get any help from Vala. Got it. So I think I'm just gonna go back here. It wouldn't be a solo queue silliness without at least one person not paying attention. So it's a 72-28 golem. I think you could use a healing valve. This world will burn. And I'm going to go down and defend against the golem. Surprisingly, we're only a level down, despite being only 4 kills down. Let's see what our Vala player is doing. He's confirmed that he is not AFK.
This world. Your golem is complete, but it is weaker.
Our golem is much weaker. Much, much weaker.
Choose a talent.
So, oh, it's a nice vault out of the way there by Vala, by the enemy Vala. And look at this, I do see I accidentally catch Nova out in the open. And if we can catch up to her, that'd be nice. And she's right there, I can see her. I can see her. I'm pretty sure I cannot shadow charge without a target. So Raynor went down. I wish Diablo would mount up. There we go. Oh, come on, Diablo. Get out of that stun. So we're going to lose our front turret here. I'm getting just poked to death by Vala. Gotta be careful of Nova, who is probably looking to get a quick, easy kill, as she always does. Nova shooting Vala through the wall there. That was pretty cool. Oh, right into the root. Right into the root. Well, we should be able to take down the golem here before the keep goes down. Or the fort, rather. So, we are able to take it down. Our golem didn't do so hot. He got a turret. That's pretty good. That's better than nothing. And a team was able to take out our knights, which Vala and I could have easily taken if Vala was reading chat. I don't know if this Illidan realizes that's not going to work against Nova. Yeah. As an Illidan player who mains Illidan, you don't ever want to do that against Nova. Really against anyone, unless if you have enough lifesteal or you pick the Metamorphosis talent. So after 6.5 minutes, it's 11-3. We surprisingly didn't lose much on our first golem, even though we were down by 72-28 skulls. Top lane is being pushed pretty badly right now, but I'm gonna hold strong here. And basically, I'm just going to try to soak the lanes as much as possible. Picking them up, slamming them down. Raynor already calling a GG and leaving the game, and let's see who is the one who has died the most often in this game. What do you know? It's Raynor! So congrats to Papaloo for being our token that guy. You've won the award of that guy today. Congrats to Papaloo. Apparently I do have Apocalypse. Or not Apocalypse, Lightning Breath. I did not realize that I unlocked that. Ain't that something? So there's the hunt and getting the Lightning Breath. Lightning Breath actually doing a lot of damage there. Illidan, not quite sure if you... He did like 40 backflips. Oh, God. Oh, that's great. That is just great. Diablo, there you go. There you go. Not going to go down there. So, yeah. So, we've already had a rage quit. We've already had an AFKer. We're going for the triple whammy here. The only thing else that we're leaving is the token that guy rager. I mean, rage quit... Sometimes I would say considered, it might be a rager, but we're waiting for the blow up. Waiting for the chat blow up. I think a rage quit and a rager are two different things. So we're only 2 levels down. My entire team is dead. Except Illidan, who is AFK. The purposeful AFK. We might be going for the. It's going to be the hat trick plus one here. We've got the AFK because he says he's AFK, the rage quitter. The other AFKer who's not actually AFK, he just wasn't paying attention. And yeah. Another day here in solo queue silliness. Gotta love it. Gotta love it. Somehow, inexplicably, we got 18 skulls. I think that was... I'm pretty sure that was all of Raynerbot. Just Raynerbot. And let's see who else. That was Arthas who left the battle. Very nice. So we now have almost even the amount. Well, technically it is even the amount because Illidan is choosing to be AFK at the fountain. And Vala, I'm pretty sure, is not a real person anyway. So there are actually more bots than human players in this game. Very nice indeed. Let's see what I can do here. Let's see how much damage my lightning breath does against the Grave Golem here. There we go, lighten him up. I really feel that lightning breath should do more damage. I really do. Whoa, a new Barak just says, the heck with it all, man. We're up by 3 levels. We're just gonna charge everybody. Illidan wishing that he just stayed AFK in the fountain. Ends up dying first. Oh, Vala decided to start playing again. Good. Picking him up, slamming him down. Gonna stun Nova here, but it doesn't look like Arthas bot is in the... He's not in the assisting mood, that's okay. I don't blame you, Arthas bot. If I was a bot, I wouldn't be in the assisting mood either. Alright, it's 10.5 minutes, it's 20-3. And the enemy is on our... They're on our core here. Well, at least I can say that I didn't have to use Diablo's passive and have to insta-res. Actually, Raynerbot saves me there from the triple tap. It was very kind of him. There's Nova doing about 25% of my health in one shot. Typical Nova, and yeah, that's an under 11-minute loss there, so shout out to those token nerds. You know who you are. And I got to give the MVP to Raynerbot for picking up the slack after Papaloo so quickly said GG after dying the most times on our team. So thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And we'll see you next time for more solo queue silliness. So long, everybody.